When B.B. King died last year, you guys have heard this one, never played it with anyone. I call it cruise control about B.B. King. I call him watermelon shitloose. Watermelon Chitlin, he was born at cruise control. Called him Watermelon Chitlin, he invented cruise control. From the day he pushed the button, got the blues and rock and roll. When he went to Kansas City, they all came out to see. And when he went to St. Louis, they were all full of sleep. But when he pulled into Chicago, they got down on their knees.
Here I am back in downtown Northampton. My name's Downtown Daniel Evans, doing some more shoots for our Speak Up America for the adults and messages to the world for the little kids. And we've got a gentleman here.
Corey.
His name is Corey, he said. And what we're asking about today is someone closer to me and my family has helped write up this, we'll call it a proposition amendment for the ballot in the midterm coming up 2 years from now. We're out here now on Columbus Day weekend waiting for the election next month. But we're trying to get ahead of the curve with everything that's happened the last 4 months in America. All of the shootings, finding out that cops are gun happy, public's gun happy, politicians aren't making the people happy. The court system is giving one person 30 years for the same crime and same circumstances, and another one who looks like a better human being to them next to nothing or just probation for the same things. So we have written up here what we call the equity and honesty ballot proposal. And I'd like to ask Corey what he thinks of something that would make the police have to take drug testing and honesty tests twice a year, one written, one oral. The same for the politicians we elect and the people they appoint to these big departments. Also, the court officers, which mean the DA, the public defender's office, and the judges, and probation. Now, that's a lot of people to try to make honest, and we know just making them test alone won't solve all of the problem. But how do you feel about this possibly being good for society, and at least the first step to giving equity back to the system?
I agree, I think it's a good thing to test, and both drug and honesty tests, or polygraphs, however you want to call it, for police, court officers, judges, I mean, everybody who's in the system should be held accountable if they're not honest and doing what they're supposed to do, and the police especially. I mean, I know people who are in the state police department who are drug users, heroin addicts,
and someone they don't know make sure the judge steps on. We've got to get equal balance of those scales, you're saying. And we appreciate your comment. But, it struck me also when you were just saying that it isn't just the police. The reason we took it to the politicians and the courts especially is because the imbalance of sentences.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, the way the court system works, I can go in front of the judge and get hit with the book, and somebody whose lawyer is friends with a judge, or that's how it works in there. Like if you know somebody, then you might be okay. But if you go in there just a regular Joe, you don't have any connections.
You're done. The fork's in you before you go. And that is the way, unfortunately, most people feel. They're
going
to be found guilty, and it's up to them to prove themselves innocent. Yeah. Not that they walk in, they're innocent. And they got to prove, you're guilty already.
Guilty until proven innocent, unfortunately. They might say innocent until proven guilty, but it's the other way around.
Well, thank you, sir, and bless your opinion.
We
appreciate you having on Speak Up America. Stay blessed.
All right. Have a good day.
Now, we've all heard of the Texas two-step. Well, I got tired of Texas having the only one. So anyone who knows how to figure out a little dance, we got our own Massachusetts two-step now. We have one of the long-standing supervision people from Brugger's here, so he'll tell you who he is.
Hi, my name's Alan Hastings.
Yeah, and he has an opinion on what we've been talking about today, this week out here, Columbus Day weekend of the year 2016. And what it's about is we have that amendment that we're thinking of sending up as a proposition ballot, not only in the state of Massachusetts, but I've got people who are going to put it on websites all over the country. And it's called the Honesty and Equity Proposition Ballot, for the people to vote on, making the politicians, those that they appoint, all court officers, including judges, and probation, and police officers truth tested twice a year and drug tested twice a year. We're looking for solutions the public sorely needs to alleviate the shootings both ways between cops and public, all the riots because of them. We all know that too many people in the system are in bed with way many more people than their wives, and this is what we're doing this for and about. And we'd love for Alan to say what he thinks of this possibly being a first step to alleviate too much wrongdoing in the system.
Sure. Well, I just think that there's scandals everywhere now. You open a paper every day, there's three, four scandals, corporations, politicians, just nonstop. And it's about time they did something to try to alleviate the problem or get it, make it better.
And do you think that they would ever vote this in themselves to make themselves honest, or is this something the people are going to have to do if it's ever going to get done?
It has to be something the people do.
Well, thank you. That's what we're hoping to hear from the public.
Thank you.
Stay blessed. Thank you, Katie.
Thank you.
Downtown Daniel back here in downtown Northampton. This time you've heard before opinions about the truth testing, about the drug testing, up and down the line, in the politics, the courts, and the policing of America. But there's a second part to this amendment which states that a 1% tax locally would be levied on all paper products, with the tax money going directly to pay for the polygraph and written testing, but also to create an investigative unit in the public defender's office, where, as we know, they'll spend $100,000 to convict someone and won't even give the public defender $10,000 to do his total case. And anytime you have $1 against 10 in anything in America, usually the 10 wins. And it's like gambling in Vegas. You know where the odds are for promise. So we have someone here who'd like to say a few words about what they think about this section.
My name is Alex Moselle, and personally, I think that the justice system in America is largely arbitrary. There are vastly different sentences for crimes based on ethnicity, race, gender, age, all these things. And one thing that we need to keep in mind is the arbitrary nature related to income and resources and ability to hire defense and lawyers. And I think with extra resources going to the public defender's office, it will only make it even the playing field, like you said, and it'll be make it more likely to find out if someone is really guilty or not guilty.
Well, thank you, because I think as we wrote it up here in the proposition for the ballot, spending $1 to 10 to convict against someone proving their innocence with 10% of the same, would you say it might be like putting a toy poodle with no teeth in the ring with the pit bull?
That sounds like a good metaphor.
Good analogy. Thank you, my brother. We appreciate it.
Thank you.
Bless you. I don't care if we get rained out, just so who's here is appreciative. That's what music's about. Yeah, this is called The Reunion. This is one of the songs closest to my heart that I wrote in 1976 on the way to the Montreal Olympics. But being called The Reunion, it has special meaning. If you saw the articles that they did in the newsprint and on Facebook, then you know that after the 15, 16 years I've spent here, I've been separated from my wife of 20 years, that we have 4 kids and 4, 9 grandchildren. And now it's a different meaning for the reunion, because the ticket I bought on Amtrak is to go to our retirement trailer. And as it was in the beginning, finish out my life with the woman who is my soulmate. So reunion has a very positive meaning to me this month. Yeah, it's time to hit the road. Yes, girl, I travel. Yes, all alone. Yes, you know. Yes, all my life I've known. Yes, that I'd be out on this road. Out on this road. And now that I am old, yes, now once again I pack my bag and my role. I'm getting my guitar, gonna go and be once again out on the road, At the reunion, I'll be here with you. Yes, baby, I'll see you at a reunion. At a reunion. I'll be with you. At a reunion, baby, I'll see you, be with you, yes, at a reunion, I'll see you, I'll be, yes, with you, baby, at a reunion, at a reunion, at the reunion, I'll see you, I'll be, yes, with you, baby, at a reunion.
And now we've got a New Yorker person here who's got an opinion. So we're getting them from all over the place here in downtown Noho. Anyhow, again, the issues are truth and drug testing of politicians, cops, court officers, and the ones the politicians and elected officials appoint. Yeah, we've got this fellow here who seems to have some very solid thoughts on what I'm talking about here. So we'll take the truth and drug testing first. Introduce yourself, sir.
Hi, I'm Isaac from New York City. Here to give my opinion or my support.
And what do you think about this being a first step? Not necessarily a solution, but a first step to all the equity we see just isn't there between the police, the public, the courts, the politician. We see nothing but shooting, violence. It's getting to the point in the old song, nobody's right when everybody's wrong.
That's a good song.
Do you look at this as maybe, possibly, the first baby step to getting equity back in the system from both sides?
I would completely agree if every Joe Blow on the street's gonna be open to being tested or scrutinized or investigated. Why shouldn't those people on the other side of the law, police officers, politicians, city government, why shouldn't they also be held to the same test and same standard?
And at least if this was on the ballot and passed, at least then when we, and everything has to be visible, it says right in there, it has to be released on their website, the answers they gave to the public. So we'll know that they're really what they say they are. Because unfortunately, the system is saying, we can't trust what you say. And we sure don't like a whole lot of what you do. So there's the other flip coin. The second part of this amendment would also state a one person, 1 cent paper tax. actually will make that tissue. It's written as tissue. So every time you're in the comfort station, every time you blow your nose, wipe up with a wipe on your counter, you're helping support funds that would not only pay for the truth testing and the drug testing, but also will create an investigative squad for the public defender's office in every county that can investigate for them the fact that the defendant says could help clear their name, which right now we know they spend $100,000 and they might not even give the public defender lawyer a grant. I don't know what they give, but it's nowhere near $100,000 for one case, not even $10,000. And even $10,000 to $100 is like I say, like throwing a toothless chihuahua or a toy poodle in the ring with a pit bull. And do you have any opinions on the inequities in the court system and the judges' sentencing from that point of view?
I would beyond 100% support that sort of investment in equitable taxing to support investigation and equal protection and equal protection, equal representation in courts. Once you're in the criminal justice system, you're not getting out. You're never coming back to a normal, productive, accepted, non-stigmatized life. So anything to help that, 100% behind.
Because we all know now with the Coreys, you know, they hold any little thing you do against you for life. It's not like we were raised when we were real little and you pay your crime and you go on.
You're stuck with it forever.
Hold it over your head forever. And one last thing, I'm sure you're quite aware that it isn't just a non-color color thing in the court. Though people of color are 7 times more likely to get stopped and arrested, get 2 to 3 the amount of time for the same sentences. But don't you agree that if we had truth testing, we could ask all of these judges, did you divvy out your punishment with an even balance of scale, no matter what their ethnicity, color, station in life? Whether they were a friend, whether a lawyer knew him and said, well, this is a good guy, but the good guy who was is a bad guy now, just like the good guy we were last week doesn't count now either.
I would totally agree with that as well. It's interesting that while the majority of people in prison, like you said, 7 times more of non-white background, the majority of drug users are actually white individuals. So with equitable representation, equitable testing,
equitable
hopefully would balance
sentencing.
It out, and equitable sentencing would hopefully balance it out. Cool.
Thank you.
Thank you.
And you have a blessed day.
You too. Take care.
Thank you, New York.
Must be some kind of way out of here, said the Joker to the thief. There's too much confusion, I can't get no relief. Businessmen, they come and drink my wine, they smoke my herb, but none can level on the mind. No one from underneath this earth. No reason to get excited now. The thief, he kindly spoke. There are many here among us now who think that life is but a joke. You and I, we've been through that, and this is not our fate. so let us not talk falsely now, cause the hour is getting late. All along the watchtower, the princes kept their view. As the women came and went, yes, there were servants too. Outside in the cookie stand, a wild cat did growl. And two riders were approaching, and the wind into how wow. The princes kept their view. Yes, as the women came and went, yes, there were servants too. Outside in the courtyard, a wild cat did growl. And two riders were approaching, and the wind began to howl. All along the watchtower, all along the watchtower.
All right.
We have another public media person here from This Is Northampton site. He'll introduce himself, and he has a few things to say about this new proposition we're fixing to work into, hopefully the ballot for the mid-election in as many communities, counties, states, hopefully nationwide as we can. And it basically is about, we propose to truth test and drug test twice a year the police, sheriffs, the DA's department, the probation department, and the judges and clerks in the system. Also, the politicians we elect and those that they appoint. And the second phase we'll get to after he gives his opinion on the first is we also want to create a 1 cent to the dollar penny tax on all tissues sold in the communities to go directly to supporting the cost of the drug and true testing, but also a squad of investigators for the public defender's office to even the playing field for the poor who, even if they are innocent, the lawyer has no tools if it's a public defender while they're in jail to go out and find these people and bring them to court to testify for them. In other words, we spend $10,000 to convict to $100 for the defense. And we all know the result. You know, the scales are not balanced. If you know somebody or you got the money, you're up here. If you got nothing, you're down here. And unless there's an even playing field, you can't get an honest verdict if you don't get all the honest truth. And I'll hand you over to Dick Cowell. He'll introduce himself and say what he thinks about these two issues.
Thank you, Daniel.
And the need in the public, hopefully.
My name's Dick Coles. I'm one of the administrators for the This Is Northampton Facebook page. I've known downtown Daniel for years. We've become good friends. I miss him when he's not around, but when he's here, he makes good things happen. For a long time, it's been money talking down to the masses. And this initiative that is being put forward by Daniel and his supporters seeks to change that. They may have the money, we have the numbers, but if the numbers are silent, we lose our power. So I certainly endorse this initiative and wish Daniel all the best in getting this to happen, getting it on the ballot, so that we the people, the numbers, can speak to the money.
And when you speak of money, as I was saying about the initiative for the investigative unit for the public defender's office. Right now, do you agree, as I've asked other people, and I think I wrote it down in the proposal,
mm-hmm.
$1 to every 100 is like throwing a pit bull or a chihuahua without teeth in the ring with the pit bull. Or a close analogy? I mean, can you make an analogy?
The way the system works now, if you're accused, you're guilty until proven innocent. And if you don't have the resources, you stay guilty. And we spend way too much of our money putting low-level offenders or non-offenders into our for-profit prison system. This is another one of those initiatives that is going to use the power of our numbers against the power of their dollars.
I appreciate that. Can I use that to say to people
Absolutely.
Further down the line? Because we need to drive that home the way you spoke it.
Thank you, Danny.
And stay blessed.
All right,
pleasure always.